I'm in Johnston County, North Carolina, marching with anti-mask protesters to what has become America's new Thunderdome, school board meetings.
North Carolina parents are desperate to get their kids back into schools. But with packed ICUs and COVID cases in children four times what they were last year, new studies in the CDC are recommending masks as a way to keep in-person learning. But packed school board meetings and new stars of the right are upset because putting on a piece of cloth is just too much.
I'm against all mandates. So from there, I don't care where it's masks, where it's vaccinations, I'm against it all.
Masks will never protect Americans.
Masks don't work. My child was suffering after wearing his mask for so long.
What kind of issues has he had?
He's had acne on his face from, you know, the mask covering and not letting his skin breathe.
Has he had COVID?
No.
But he has had acne.
Yes.
So, have you had to choose?
No.
What's wrong with having children wear masks in school?
Well, you're breathing in the toxins that your body is trying to get rid of.
How do surgeons do it?
That is a good question.
There's been some new studies that have come out both by the CDC and by even Duke University talking about masks being helpful, especially in a school situation.
I challenge anybody to put a mask on and 5 minutes later smell that funk and think it's good for you.
So there's science and then there's the smell test, and you're going with the smell test.
Yes.
What are some of the ways kids suffer when they have to wear masks?
I think breathing. I've done a little bit of research about the carbon dioxide that people were saying is an issue now with the mask.
Wearing a mask helps stop the spread of COVID in settings like a school.
But they're outside. Like right now, I mean this is a kind of example. There's kids out there playing and stuff.
Well, we're outside right now. When you go inside, isn't it beneficial to wear a mask if you're close to someone? No.
No, I don't think so.
The science says it is helpful to wear a mask so it doesn't spread when you're in close proximity indoors.
The science.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Do y'all edit this? I'm sorry.
So some people are bewildered by science, both the practice and the word. But maybe scary images like full ICUs would have an impact.
Wearing a mask, what's the harm?
Well, for kids, the harm is they can't gauge emotional awareness of other kids. They don't see the facial expressions.
Do you think not being able to see people's lower halves of face outweighs the dangers that COVID might pose to kids and communities?
Well, the dangers aren't what you think they are.
The ICUs here are full.
Yeah, but how many positive tests in all of North Carolina have died? How many are sick?
The ones in the ICU are pretty sick.
Yeah.
I've been in ICUs three times in the last year and a half with my wife and have questioned the nurses and doctors.
You have ICUs full of people suffering from COVID right now.
Do you now? Is that true? Are they just being the diagnosis on paper? I've walked through the hospitals, I've videotaped inside the hospitals, and guess what? It's not full of COVID patients.
Now I'm worried about COVID and security measures at North Carolina hospitals.
Like so many of these school board battles, it was never about just one thing, but more of a general airing of grievances.
When we got a governor here that thinks it's okay to have CRT in the classroom, they need to focus on educating and not indoctrinating our children here in North Carolina.
No CRT, that's ridiculous.
We're saving the kids from all that's going on with CRT, critical race theory.
Here in North Carolina, they don't need to learn about racism in school.
No, where are they going to learn about racism most?
Walking past one of the tobacco fields?
Well, no, not walking past the tobacco field, sir. You know, it's not like that.
It was hard to sum up the outrage of that afternoon. There were many thoughtful political statements being made. But looking around, it was difficult to miss the real catchphrase of the day.
I don't co-parent with the government.
Well, you don't want to co-parent with the government. Don't get pregnant in Texas.
There we go.
Right.
Don't get pregnant anywhere.
Your kids go to private school?
They're enrolled in public school.
Isn't that kind of co-parenting with the government?
No, it isn't, because you know why? We have a board of education. We also elect who our officials are. We get to have a voice.
Right, so you work with the government.
We do.
In parenting decisions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're in public school.
So you do kind of co-parent with the government.
In that regard, I guess, yeah. If you want to say my taxes pay for that, yeah.
But you're giving back your child tax credit.
So, I mean.
This crowd that was ready to fight for what they believed in was using the power of democracy that was bestowed upon all of us by our founding fathers.
Did you vote for school board?
No.
No.
I don't even vote.
You don't even vote?
No.
You could vote for somebody who reflects your values.
I could vote. You're right. Yeah.
But that's a hassle.
Don't take the time to do it. I'm sorry.
But at the end of the day, they saw this as a fight against something much more disturbing than kids' face coverings.
It's terrible for them to wear masks. Absolutely. But it's just absolutely terrible. It's a sign of slavery.
Wait, what?
Very basically.
Wearing a mask is a sign of slavery.
I discovered in my research also that Satanists stand 6 feet apart. They wear masks during the rituals.
Who does?
Satanists.
Satanists. Six.
Their rituals. That's 6 feet apart. Wear a mask. I don't know. Is it coincidence? I don't know. Sure. Satanism is, well, we're at war with Satan. And
how are we doing?
I think we're winning.
Good. Finally some good news.
I have no fears.
No fears, but a healthy belief in Satanism and its effect in the COVID.
Oh, absolutely.